What's going on, y'all? How y'all doing? 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 So happy to be here. You know, this is the Alf'Dawg Show. If y'all don't know, I'm just gonna let y'all know now. This is the Alf'Dawg Show. I have to tell you twice because I don't think you got it the first time. Introducing myself, G. Barry, checking in. We also got T-Bone, the Stat Man. The Stat Man, oh yeah. We're doing it big now. Oh yeah, we're doing it big. Also, host of the show, Alf'Dawg.
Oh yeah.
All right, baby.
Thank you. Thank you for that. Beautiful intro. Welcome to a brand new edition of the Alf'Dawg Show. It's great to have you all here. And this is a huge show. All of our shows is huge, but this is even more big because LeBron James has made his decision. He is signing with the Miami Heat. Oh man, has this really shook the face of the NBA and sports in general? We're going to get into all of that here today, but when I just want to know for you guys, when LeBron first said, "I'm taking my talents to South Beach," what came to your minds when he said that?
T-Bone? The first thing that really came to my mind was that, you know, okay, he really, you know, he's down for winning. He wants to win now. He wants a championship. He thinks the best thing for him is to have a group of core all-stars with him to help him out, you know, because, you know, he can't take 95% of the load, you know, 100% of the time. You know, you can't continue to play 48 minutes every game. You know, you're scoring, you know, 30 points, and you're doing everything, you're facilitating the game, you're managing everything. That can be rough. And some quality help, you know, you have a talented, uber-talented shooting guard, Dwayne Wade, and now you have The Rock, one of the rocks in the NBA, Chris Bosh, at the power forward position. That's more than solidifying help for LeBron so that he can get that goal.
Well, I mean, I was telling people this, you know, back when the playoffs, I was telling everybody, but no one wanted to believe me because they was like, oh, no, he's loyal. I mean, but it really has nothing about loyalty. It's his career, and he wants to win, and winning at the end of the day is the best thing for any type of athlete, you know, who doesn't want to win. But, you know, I think that LeBron, even though I'm a Cleveland fan and I wanted him to stay, I think this was a very good move for him, and I back him up 100%.
Well, I don't think it was his best move. I think, yes, he probably, his intentions is good. He wants to win a championship, but at the same time, he's playing with, you know, his best friends and that stuff, but he's at South Beach. You're 25 years old. You know, you want to go down. You want to jig. I mean, so you want to jig. So, like, was his intentions to win a championship, you know, is it there? How much of it is there? Or does he want to just not go through the trials and tribulations of working hard to get a championship and, you know, rely on Dwayne Wade, rely on Chris Bosh, you know, to get that? Honestly, basketball, I would have liked for him to stay in Cleveland. I think he should have stayed in Cleveland. But I think his next best option would have been with the Chicago Bulls. You already have a set team there with Derrick Rose and Carlos Boozer signed him and Joakim Noah. You have a full roster there. And LeBron James would have been the best piece of the puzzle there. But with Miami, they have to fill up their roster. Other than those three, they don't have no money, basically, to sign seven other guys, you know, and that's, to me, that's a problem.
We'll get into that.
And we're going to get into all that.
We'll get into that. So, basically, Dan Gilbert calls LeBron a coward, heartless, and also says that they'll win a championship before LeBron and the two others will even touch a ring.
Oh.
And this was all in his letter, pretty much dogging LeBron and his whole association. And I think this was pretty much you know, something that he felt that he needed to put out but wasn't professional enough, because at one, he's saying, if you will, promises that he can't back up. He doesn't have the team to back him up. He doesn't have the staff to back him up. So where does this come from, T-Bone?
Really, I think it was just a big amount of spite in Dan Gilbert's voice and his actions when he said that. He called him a coward. He accused him of quitting in Game 6 of the Eastern Conference semifinals against the Boston Celtics. He also dated back to the 2009 series in the Eastern Conference Finals against the Orlando Magic that he also quit during that final game. When you look at the tape, he says, when you look at the tape, you can see that he quit. You see that he wasn't making the necessary efforts. His body language was terrible. He was lazy at times, not involved in any of the plays, very inattentive. You know, he said all these things, and really, I think it was just a form of spite, even though you can kind of get a view of what he's saying, because really, he did look a little sloppy. You know, fans were really getting on him.
From the normal LeBron James.
Right, the game five that he had against the Celtics this year, 3 of 14, 15 points, 7 boards. Not really what we were looking for out of the then number 23. So now, number 6 is coming along, and really people are just basically saying, you know what, LeBron, you need to win this ring. You deserted your city. You know, the way you left was really, it was tumultuous how he just left. He just leaves. We had all this time during, you know, the offseason, during the months of June, the day that the playoffs ended for the Cavs on May 13th, had a lot of time to sign a lot of big-name free agents. They didn't do that. They thought they could keep him here.
That's the Cavs' fault.
Right.
We'll get into that question, too. Alf'Dawg.
Now, first off, in that Orlando series, if it was for LeBron James, the Cavs would have got swept, first off. Now,
definitely.
In that, I think what Gilbert said was out of anger, but the fans loved that. The fans wanted to hear that their owner actually cared about their team. You know, and that's what we saw. But the ramifications of it was, well, LeBron quit, you know, and all this stuff, all that. But it's strictly business, though.
Right, right, right.
But we got to remind folks, though, because maybe we're too young to understand. We're from Cleveland. Maybe we're too young to understand what the city of Cleveland, sports-wise, has gone through. I mean, they went through the shot. They went through the drive, the fumble, blowing a World Series game in the ninth inning of the World Series.
Okay. We bring up the emotions, man. Come on, man.
All of Red Right 88.
If you're 50 and up, you hurt right now.
Blowing a 3-1 lead against the Red Sox in the 2007 ALCS. The Indians haven't been anything since. I mean, so we can understand the pain, the agony of a depressed sports city in Cleveland. So when we come back, we have a lot to dissect and all of this. Does this hurt the NBA that all of these superstar players are on one team and not spread around? We'll get to all that plus more on the Alf'Dawg Show.